Right, today we're just having a look at the sort of range of tweezers we have. We have quite a few different ranges on our website. Tungsten tweezers, they're the most expensive ones. They're durable because they go in the flame. We have a standard stainless steel one. And then we have some smaller versions and cheaper versions. So little petal pullers, the fibre handled ones and the right angled ones. So I'm just going to show you roughly the sort of things you can do with tweezers. So I'm just going to make a basic flower. So you can use the tweezers to flatten out areas, pull areas, create textures on them. So I'm just going to make a little flower on the end of this rod. So I've made a base. Some petals on, and then we'll use a different tweezers for different effects on each petal. I'm just going to heat the area where my first petal is going to go. I'm just going to put some little dots on, like little pips to start me off, so I know roughly where they're going to go. Petals up. I'm making them roughly the same size. So I heat them round so they become little blobs. Fibre handled ones. First petal, just going to use the tip to squish the edge. Mash a tweezer, you can just heat your petal up and flatten it in one go. They are slightly angled, so one's a bit more thinner at the edge and that one's just straight flat. Then I've got standard tweezers. Now these have ridges on, so again you can heat your petal. Again, you can use the tweezers to fan out your little petal and it forms a little pattern on the side. If you didn't want that when you're using your tweezers, you just reheat it, take the scoring marks off. And the last one will heat the petal. Flatten it out with the mash of tweezers. And you just heat the edge, and then use one of the sharp pointed ones to pull out your petal. Quite good for delicate use, those sharp edged ones. That's the petals, different forms with using different tweezers. mistake. So we'll just make a quick bead and add a mistake on it. So I've just done a quick basic bead. So if we were doing dots on, do it in black so you can see. Precisely putting them on. And then you put one on that's slightly bigger or in the wrong place. You get any as small, the fine ones, like the tungsten, or fibre handled ones, or the right angled ones. Turn your heat down. You heat where the mistake is, just the mistake, and then using your fine tip ones, pull it off in small amounts. You don't want to be ruining your bead underneath. You just need to take off what you don't want. So keep pulling little bits off and then melt it to see if you've got rid of it. There we are. Behind a blob here. Now it's gone. So they're quite useful, the fine tip ones, for pulling out mistakes. Tweezers are also good for picking up murrini or dichroic, anything you need to add on. So you can hold it, tungsten, you can go in the flame. The rest of them mustn't go in the flame, you will melt them. So the tungsten ones are quite good for that reason. Just heat that up. So again, that's another use for tweezers, picking things up and taking things off. Made of a bead. Just going to use the mashy tweezers to flatten it. Looks like a disc. nail on, so like before making the petals, I just put two blobs where I want them. Build them up. And these will form the fins of the tail. Using the razor tool because my blobs have melted together. Tools are great for things like this, sculpting and moulding. So I'll use the little petal tweezers again. Flatten out the little fins, tail fins. Points out. Fish warm, especially on the tail. Put eyes on. Two little blobs of white. In fact, you can use mashed tweezers for squashing blobs like eyes. Another use. I'm just going to put a little black centre. Some lips on, so I'm going to the other end, make sure the tail is still warm, and again two little blobs, a bit like the tail. Just build them up. And the other thing you can use tweezers for, some people use a punty, is for pulling stringers. So the standard tweezers we'll use is quite good for just pulling a sort of a thickish stringer. So just grab the little end of your ball, wait for it to cool slightly, and then just pull to whatever one you want, whatever length you want. Sometimes if I want a thinner stringer, I will use the finer tools. So just heat a little ball. I use the angled ones. Grab the end and then pull. So the finer ones don't grab as much glass as the chunkier ones. I hope that gives you incentive to buy some tweezers. There's many variety of things you can do with them. They're a great tool. If you've got any other ideas, let us know. Thank you.